And welcome back to the Huron Arena with Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN. I'm Mike Henriksen from SportsMax Radio and calling all sports. A terrific first semifinal game. Craig, what's happening at the other tournaments this evening?
Well, the number one seed in AA survives. O'Gorman defeating Aberdeen Central 49-42.
Nice run by Aberdeen Central there.
So the O'Gorman Knights, their only loss on the season was to Sioux Falls Washington, last game of the regular season. And coming up the second semifinal game, it's Washington versus Harrisburg. At the A tournament, St. Thomas More was leading Webster by about 20. Don't have a final on that one yet.
Okay. So again, earlier this evening, it was Sully Buttes advancing to the championship round. Now, Summit will be taking on the Ethan Rustlers. Take a look at Summit, way up in the Coteau of Northeast South Dakota. That's where some serious climate change occurs.
Remember Summit? They were on such a great roll. They were here 7 years in a row until 2012, and they got three championships during that trip as well. And they love their basketball up there in Northeast South Dakota, but this is the last year of Summit High School.
They will be going in with Wabe in most sports and going in with Wabe and Wilmont in football next year. They've got a tiny little gymnasium, and this year at the end of the season they actually took the eagle off of the floor up there. There you see how they did in the districts. They defeated Great Plains Lutheran and then a tough one against Wilmont, 56-53. And then Warner.
They've won the last two state beat championships, as well as the state last two championships in volleyball.
And so it has been this region that has provided, because Summit won two in a row, correct?
That is correct.
Yep, so this region has produced four straight state titles, either Summit or Warner. Summit is able to get back to the state tournament. Yesterday, they defeated McLaughlin 58-47. But it was tighter than that. They hit some free throws down the stretch to pull away. And now tonight, they take on Ethan. Let's take a look at the starting lineups. Nicolette Neeland, 5'10 and a junior. She had a very effective game inside yesterday. Sierra Redland, 5'6 and a senior. Whitney Zerbel is a 6-foot junior,
averaging 11 points a game.
Carissa Chamley, 5'9 and a senior. And Calissa Paraboom, 5'6 and a senior.
15 points a game. Really, she didn't score at all until late in the second half.
Meanwhile, the Summit Eagles are coached by Mark Omdahl.
11th year.
Mark has done an incredible job. As you mentioned, they were at the state tournament 7 years in a row. So now 8 out of the 11 years that he has coached, they have made the state tournament. Mark is a farmer up there in Grant County, has a couple of little kids, took the job basically because they couldn't find anybody to take the job, as is the case in so many small towns. But he has been terrific at it. And as a matter of fact, he now has, in those 11 years, 235 wins and just 32 losses. So he is averaging less than 3 losses per year with 235 wins to go with it. It is Summit and Ethan tonight. We'll take a look at the Ethan Rustlers, the only undefeated girls team in the state of South Dakota. When we come back, you're watching the South Dakota Class B Championships right here from the Huron Arena on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. We are so happy that you are joining us on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Just a reminder, while we've got a moment, you can order DVDs from your team. All three games come in your DVD set for just $19.95. Find out more by going to sdpb.org. Or if you happen to be at one of the tournaments, you can always stop by the SDPB booth in the lobby of each venue. Craig and I are looking forward to being down in Sioux Falls next week for the boys' AA tournament in the brand new Denny Sanford Premier Center. Meanwhile, of course, the Class A tournament going on at the Rushmore Plaza Civic Center out in Rapid City, and the B at the Barnett Center up in Aberdeen. Coming up tonight, we told you about Summit. Let's tell you about Ethan, the Ethan Rustlers. Ethan, located directly south of Mitchell, South Dakota.
First time they've been to the state tournament since 1981.
And they have a large contingent of fans here. The Rustlers are coached by Tom Young. We'll talk about Dr. Tom in just a moment. Again, sort of a medium-sized school when it comes to Class B.
They've been huge this year, though. They're 23-0 coming into the tournament. They get the win last night.
Let's see how they got here. They defeated Howard, and then they knocked off a very solid Hanson team in convincing manner. They defeated Chester area in the region, 53-27. And then in their opening game, they downed Viberg Hurley. But Craig, the real key to look at is on the right side of those numbers. The amount of points that Ethan is giving up is minuscule.
28 points a game. And the reason why is because they play an amazing 1-3-1 zone with a 6-1 post player in that top position. A lot of length causing a lot of problems for a lot of teams this year.
Let's take a look. There you see their starting lineups. Only one senior on the roster, that starts. That's Darby Gustafson. Otherwise, one other senior, Morgan Tuttle, she'll come off the bench.
Mike, I have never seen this situation where you have four sophomores on an undefeated team at the state tournament.
They were very, very good last year. But this year, they have put it together. Ellie Hone, Janae Gustafson, Darby Gustafson, Rachel Hawkins, and Casey Barcher. Darby and Janae are sisters, and you will also see Carly Gustafson, an eighth grader, come off of the bench. Ethan is coached by Dr. Tom Young. Tom was longtime coach at Mitchell Christian, took the job at Mitchell High School for a while, and now is back on the bench in Ethan. We'll be back to the Huron Arena right after this timeout. You're watching the Girls B Championships on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
Perfect.
Poor AJ.
He's going to hate it.
Oh.
Maybe let's wait. There we go. With Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN. I'm Mike Henriksen from SportsMax Radio.
By the way, Mike, all three of the top seeds in the girls' tournament have advanced. O'Gorman in AA, St. Thomas More in A, and Silly Buttes here at Class B.
We get ready for our second semifinal game, Ethan versus Summit tonight. Nice to see Coach Aaron Johnston here at the ball game.
Oh, he's got popcorn.
He does.
Lucky dog.
AJ, bring some of that down here.
Nice.
It is. So he's here taking in the festivities.
They find out Monday where the Jacks will play in the NCAA women's basketball tournament.
What a run they have made, and it's mostly been their defense that has turned things around here down the stretch for the SDSU women. That was fun to watch last week at the Summit League tournament in the Denny Sanford Premier Center. There's Coach Tom Young, Dr. Tom Young. By the way, last night I misspoke and I said that Dr. Tom is a dentist. He is not. He's an eye doctor. I missed it by 4 inches. All right? On the average human being.
Oh, by the way, you have an appointment on Monday, Mike.
Exactly. But no, we've known Tom for a very long time. As a matter of fact, a few years ago, he helped us out during one of the boys' tournaments up in Aberdeen after Mitchell Christian had been eliminated. So Tom is enjoying being back on the bench. He had stepped down from Mitchell Christian, sat out a year, took the Mitchell public job after Gary Munson left. And then that was an awful lot of travel. So he sat out another couple of years. The Ethan job opened up, and he took it. Let's meet our players in tonight's second semifinal game here on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our second semifinal game between the Summit Eagles and the Ethan Rustlers. Now, let's meet the starters for tonight's game. At guard for the Eagles, a 5'6 senior, number 3, Calissa Paraboon. At guard for the Rustlers, a 5'7 sophomore, number 22, Rachel Hawkins. At guard for the Eagles, a 5'6 senior, number 4, Sierra Redland. At guard for the Rustlers, a 5'9 sophomore, number 24, Janae Gustafson. At forward for the Eagles, a 5'9 senior, number 5, Carissa Chanley. At center for the Rustlers, a 6'1 senior, number 32, Darby Gustafson. At center for the Eagles, a 6-foot junior, number 34, Whitney Zirbel. At forward for the Rustlers, a 5'9 sophomore, number 40, Ellie Hone. At forward for the Eagles, a 5'10 junior, number 40, Nicolette Nealand. And a guard for the Rustlers, a 5'7 sophomore, number 44, Casey Barcher. The Eagles are coached by Mark Omdahl, Brittany Hills, and Brian Olerich. The Rustlers are coached by Tom Young and Eric Eisenbride. The official for tonight's game are Jason Loggy, James Benning, and Aaron Vandenberg. Alternate is Darren Vetch. Ladies and gentlemen, let's play state tournament basketball!
A good crowd on hand as Dr. Tom Young gives the final instructions to his Ethan Rustlers.
We're going to see a really good 1-3-1 zone by the Rustlers. Can the Summit Eagles get some good looks with that zone? It's important for Paraboom and Chamley and Zirbel and probably Nealand to be able to hit from the outside. If not, it could be a long night.
Tip is up and controlled by the Eagles. Not many times that you can...
Oh, man-to-man defense.
Yeah,
here.
Coming out on man-to-man, a switch-up by Tom Young.
They have not played man-to-man much at all on the season.
By the way, I was going to say, it's not often that you can watch a state tournament basketball game and be on your deck grilling, like I just found out they are in Pier while watching us. We appreciate that.
Lucky.
First, yeah, exactly. Save some for us.
Well, the Eagles, they're gonna play man-to-man, too.
Foul on Nealand right off the bat. The drive by Janae Gustafson, one of the super sophomores for this Ethan Rustler team.
Just amazes me, Mike. Again, you got 4 sophomores in the starting lineup that play major minutes for a team that's undefeated. It just shows the talent that they have had this year.
Free throw is up and good. Ethan is on top. And also, for those of you familiar with those Mitchell Christian boys teams that Tom Young coached, he is not afraid to milk the clock and be very, very patient.
Ethan is also a very good free throw shooting team.
So the early lead for the Ethan Rustlers. 2-0, our score here in the early going. Ball tipped out of bounds. It will stay with the Eagles. On the dribble, out at the point, that's Carissa Chamley. Chamley, a 5-second violation. She did not advance towards the basket in 5 seconds while being closely guarded. So turn it over to the Rustlers. Man-to-man defense by the Eagles, working that perimeter. Ellie Hone off to Rachel Hawkins. On the high post, Gustafson. Feeds it right side to Darby Gustafson. Darby with the left hand, puts it up no good, but she draws the foul. That will go on Whitney Zirbel.
Yeah, Whitney was not set at all. She was rolling right with the play. Made it an easy call.
Darby Gustafson.
70% shooter. Now watch with Zirbel. Just, she kept moving. And
yep. That free throw is up and good as well. 3-0. 6.5 minutes left to play here in the third, or in the first period. The winner gets Sully Buttes. And whoever loses sets up a terrific third place game. Nice entry pass and the bucket by Whitney Zirbel.
Zirbel needs to have a big night. She's 6 foot, got nice size for the Eagles.
Rustlers. Left hand, layup up and good by Janae Gustafson. And a timeout called by Mark Omdahl. Omdahl will call the early timeout. 6:02 to play in the first period. 5-2 the score.
Nice crowds tonight. A lot of those. Here's this last play. Here's the drive by Gustafson. You can follow SDPB Sports on your mobile device all season long. Frequent updates on all South Dakota High School Championship events on Facebook and on Twitter. Search SDPB Sports. Join the conversation at hashtag SDHoops15.
After the quick timeout, some defensive adjustments is what Mark Omdahl wanted to make.
Ethan's saying in that man-to-man.
Clarissa Pierboom. Round on the right side, the ball knocked away, out of bounds. It will stay with Summit. Set to inbound is Sierra Redland. Inside, shot put up by Chamley, no good, and the rebound controlled by the Rustlers.
Good matchup with Zirbel being matched up with Darby Gustafson.
On the left side, Janae Gustafson, cross-court pass over to Ellie Hone. Back out top to Hawkins. The dish back to Darby Gustafson. The three on the wing, up and off the heel of the rim, no good. But the weak side rebound run down in the corner by Casey Barcher. Good patience again by this Rustler team. Now under 5 minutes, a reverse layup up and good. 7-2, Ethan. There you see the score and the time.
Nice reverse layup.
That was pretty. Pierboom lost the handle, out of bounds it goes, and we'll step aside. The Ethan Rustlers with the early lead, and we're back with more right after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Welcome back to the Huron Arena with Craig Maddock. I'm Mike Henriksen. The Summit Eagles with an early deficit and the Ethan Rustlers with the basketball.
Well, Ethan's 2 for 3 from the line. All those shots coming inside.
Again, Ethan, such patience on offense. Hawkins inside. Darby Gustafson keeps the ball high, but Chamley tips the pass away. A three traveling. Sierra Redland took the hop without taking a dribble to get herself set. Nice to see James Benning actually demonstrating. James is one of our officials. He was demonstrating it for Mark Omdahl as to why that call was made. What a tough shot by Darby Gustafson, 6'1" and a senior. Summit needs some points and they need them in a hurry. Chamley, covered by Hawkins, to Redland. Ball tipped away, but a foul gonna be whistled on Janae Gustafson.
First foul of the game for the Rustlers.
Inbound pass goes to Chamley. Carissa Chamley, 5'9" and a senior. You see that brace on her left leg? She tore her ACL earlier this year. Paraboom not able to get it to fall.
That was down twice before it came out.
Chamley, though, they expected her to be done for the year. She missed about 6 games, couldn't stand to miss her senior year, and is just playing with the pain.
Yeah, that's going to go against Carly Gustafson.
That will be the second team foul on Ethan.
Carly here going up, number 34 there with the push on Nicolette Nealon.
Jacqueline Bluedorn will check into the lineup for the Summit Eagles. Chamley comes into the front court. Again, man-to-man defense by the Rustlers.
Marcher had 4 threes in last night's game. Look for her to maybe fire from outside.
Paraboom too strong. She got a look she wanted. Up ahead, there's the trailer. Darby Gustafson counted and to the foul line.
Pretty good movement. Yep, coming down the lane and foul by Bluedorn.
And a timeout going to be called by Mark Omdahl. He has now used 2 timeouts here in this first quarter. But, Craig, you can't let this thing get away from you early.
No, you can't. And Ethan in transition on that last play, really good transition, looking for the open player coming right down the lane. And basically, they beat Summit back the other end.
Indeed, they did. And Darby Gustafson again. She is 6'1 and a senior. She can move. And just a very, very solid all-around player.
Mike, you and I and the rest of the SDPB team here in Huron, we are next week live at the South Dakota High School AA Boys Basketball Championship. AA tournament on SDPB1. The Class A tournament next week will be on SDPB2. And Class B from Aberdeen will be on SDPB3. Plus, all the tournament action is live online at sdpb.org.
By the way, Darby Gustafson. Darby was one of the youngest riders in the Tour de Yankton. That's the day before the inaugural Tour Dakota. In 2005, Darby, her dad, and her uncle Kurt did the first 70-mile trek together. She was 8. She was 8 years old, and she rode her bike 70 miles. Free throw is good. Ethan with that 10-point lead. Kick it back out. Paraboom, the look. Got it. That was desperately needed by the Summit Eagles.
Her 71st tray of the year.
Rotated around to Ellie Hone. Cone, Barcher, Gustafson. Got the ball caught on her hip, and she traveled. On that dribble, she just got the ball a little bit caught on her hip. Traveling violation, turns it back over to Summit.
I'm just guessing, but I'm thinking maybe the Rustlers are not in a zone because of the dangerous three-point shooting that the Summit Eagles can bring you. Offensive foul.
Chamley using that left arm, trying to spin away from the defender. Offensive foul. That will be the fourth team foul on Summit. Winding down this first quarter. Working the perimeter, now back door to Barcher, shot no good. Rebound, that was Hone. Jump ball, alternating possession. It stays with the Ethan Rustlers.
Zip of a pass to back door. Barcher just couldn't get it to go.
The drive, a foul before the shot.
No doubt about it. Ethan's challenging the paint, going down low. Chamley picks up her second foul.
And that is the fifth team foul on Summit.
Sierra Redlin reporting in.
The inbound pass goes all the way out top to Hone. Gustafson traveled. Just a little bit of indecision there. She was trying to be quick, but instead she was in a hurry and shuffled those feet. Chamley.
The big three-point shooters for the Eagles. Paraboom, Chamley, and Redlin.
In for Whitney Zirbel. That's Michaela Zirbel, the freshman, who's in the lineup now. Paraboom will drive, put it up, no good, but draws the foul. So she will step to the free throw line.
Kind of think that's what the Eagles might have to do. You know, challenge those bigs down on the low block. Maybe try to get them in foul trouble.
72% free throw shooter is Melissa Paraboom. 82%, excuse me. And she misses that one.
Yeah, she's an 80%. Made both of her free throw attempts last night.
Got that one. So here comes Ethan. Tom Young has been known to take a last shot, eating the final minute off of the clock. They're not going to do that this time, I don't believe. But they're not going to take anything that isn't a layup.
Whitney Zirbel following Darby Gustafson wherever she goes.
Out top, that's Janae Gustafson. Again, no shot clock in Class B. There's a drive, the layup, no good. Rebound controlled by the Rustlers, and they will get another opportunity at it. Gustafson, off to Carly Gustafson. The drive with the left hand, no good. Darby, the putback, no good. Another offensive rebound, no. But at the end of one, Ethan on top, 12-6. We're back with more after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen from the Huron Arena. Quarter number two, Craig, defense is the strength of both of these teams, and we're seeing it tonight.
We talked about how Ethan is only giving up 28 points a game. Summit, they're only giving up 34 points per game. Now last night, Ethan, they gave up 14 points in the first quarter to Viberg Hurley. but only gave up 20 the rest of the game.
Eagles come out. Carissa Chamley back in the ballgame. Off to Paraboom. Paraboom uses the high screen, kicks it off.
Giving up some close shots.
Revlin. Back out to Chamley.
Summit does not want to get into a running game either. They have no problem slowing this pace. Mark Omdahl even said last night, that's not who they are. They like to slow it down.
Revlin gets it off to Chamley. Revlin was open for a moment. Hawkins, though, great athleticism, just reacted so well defensively, and a blocking foul whistled.
Ellie Holm will pick up her first. Oh, wait, check that.
That's going to go on Rachel Hawkins, the 5'7" sophomore.
Her second.
Rachel's dad, Tim, an administrator with Ethan, former SDSU football player. Eagles set to inbound.
And you got three Gustafsons out there on the floor for the Rustlers.
Yep, all three of the Gustafson sisters, senior, sophomore, and eighth grader.
Hone out. And coming in is Hawkins. Who's going to take the shot for
Nealon
Summit?
She's not known as a three-point shooter. She was wide right, but she was open.
Well, she's only had three three-pointers all year.
That's not a bad idea, though, there, Craig. If you hit that, then suddenly that changes everything that you think about Nicolette Nealon defensively. And you suddenly have to respect that shot. That shot put up, no good. And here come the Eagles with another opportunity. Paraboom almost got to her spot. Instead, taken away by Hawkins.
Now doing that little dribble drive offense where you come into the paint and you kick it out to the wing. Sometimes it's better to take that shot in the paint instead of trying to go back out hitting for three.
Janae Gustafson gives it up to Rachel Hawkins. Clock moves under 6 minutes. Neither team has scored here in the quarter. Darby Gustafson covered by Nicolette Nealon. Gustafson with the left hand, got it to roll.
Going right after Zirbel.
We've seen her make that move several times. I saw her in the regional championship against Chester. We saw it last night also, and there's a reach-in foul. That'll go on Casey Barcher.
That's her first. Coming in for Summit, Whitney Zirbel. Coming out is Blue Dorn.
Chamley on the dribble. Gives it up to Paraboom. Paraboom lost the handle, double dribbled. That was an unforced error. We haven't seen many of those tonight from any of the four teams that have played this evening in the semifinals. Rustlers will walk it into the front court. Rachel Hawkins. Hone back to Carly Gustafson, the 5'11 eighth grader, hits the jumper. As we go under the 5 minute mark, a 10 point lead. That matches the biggest of the night. Paraboom got a good look at the three, couldn't get it to fall. Up ahead, here come the Rustlers. Gustafson, no. Rebound pulled down by Nicolette. And then almost a steal, and we'll step aside. As Darby Gustafson can't keep it in play. A 10-point lead for the Rustlers. We're back to the Huron Arena after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. There's that little jump shot from Carly Gustafson. She's now on the bench. 10-point lead. It was 12-2. Now 16-6. So that matches the biggest lead. Nealon, she'll take the medium jumper. No good. Rebound on the weak side.
Just two Hawkins. Baskets in a quarter and a half for Summit.
And a foul on the drive. Hawkins took it to the basket.
Sierra Redlin, her first. Now next foul by Summit. Bonus time for Ethan.
Inbound pass. Barcher. Again, this Rustler team just so fundamentally sound, Craig. The way they catch the ball, the way they hold the ball high over their head. The way they catch it ready to shoot, just like that, by Hone, although she couldn't get it to fall.
Well, I mentioned the two baskets for the Eagles. But I tell you what, Eagles defensively,
yeah,
holding the Rustlers, a team that's going 60 points a game, to 16 points in a quarter and a half.
Chamley. Covered by Gustafson. Tries to get it off to Zirpel, and a foul going to be whistled. Who's it against?
Going to go on Janae Gustafson.
It will. Gustafson of Ethan. Coming in for Summit is Michaela Zirpel, the 5'6 freshman. Coming out is Carissa Chamley. Back into the lineup for Ethan is Carly Gustafson, the 8th grader. She'll come in for big sister Janae. Back into a zone defense now by the Rustlers. Much more familiar seeing this.
A very good 1-3-1.
Good ball movement though. They find an open spot. Shot no good, but the offensive rebound by Zirbel.
Good job to bring that back out. Didn't have any kind of position to shoot the ball.
Swing it side to side. That's the key against his zone, but that one stolen away. Backside defense by Hawkins. Shot no good. Nicolette Neeland with the rebound. Big sister Alex had a real nice season down at Mount Marty. We saw Tom Schlingen get honored at halftime in the last game. All those years in Scotland as a high school coach, now the college coach at Mount Marty.
Summit, 2-for-9 shooting.
Zirbel gives it back to Paraboom.
You can see that zone right there on the TV screen and how Summit trying to find an open spot. Oh, and threw it away. Second straight possession.
Cross-court pass caught by Hone. She'll give it up to Gustafson. Darby has it blocked, but a foul whistle.
And Whitney Zirbel will pick up her second.
And that will be the 7th team foul. So consequently, it is 1-1 the rest of the way. In this case, it's 2 because she was in the act of shooting. Free throw is good. Biggest lead of the night. Point lead.
The Summit, get it into single digits before halftime.
Both these coaches outstanding. You know that they're going to make adjustments at halftime. Nealon works it to Paraboom in the corner. No. Rebound by Hawkins on the weak side. How many times, Craig, have we seen players coming up with rebounds when they're on the weak side? Weak side means opposite of where the ball is. Gustafson on the drive with the left hand. No, off the heel of the rim, and Zirbel with the rebound. Chamley will come into the front court.
You get the 6-1, Darby Gustafson playing that top.
Meanwhile, Carly Gustafson at 5'11 is also helping out front.
Try to find the open spot in that open zone. Right there, it's open.
Yep, and then the kick out, the three, no. Rebound, foul going to be whistled on Whitney Zirbel.
That's going to be number three.
And Ethan will march to the other end to shoot the 1-1. Checking in for Summit is Blue Dorn. She will come in, and Whitney Zirbel will take a chair.
Almost able to bank that one home.
Yep.
Two for two from the line tonight.
She makes that one, so she will shoot the bonus. Of course, tomorrow night is a huge night with the Spirit of Sioux Award, the Spirit of Six Award, our opening ceremonies tomorrow night. A 14-point lead. Back into the lineup for Ethan, Jessica Endress. Actually, she's seeing her first action. 5'7 and a freshman.
Yeah, she got in the game last night.
Yep. We do have some halftime entertainment coming up for you. Paraboom, corner, no. There's Neeland with the weak side rebound. Back to Chamley, and they'll reset the offense. Off to Zirbel. Back to Chamley. Cross court, Chamley, three. No, heel of the rim. She runs it down herself. Paraboom, the drive with the left hand, no. Neeland put it up. She was fouled. Neeland will step to the line, and she will be shooting two. Nicolette, a 69% free throw shooter. Foul is whistled on Jessica Endress.
Oh.
Nicolette, a state place winner in the weights in track, if I remember correctly. Second free throw, no good. Here come the Rustlers with a chance at the final shot. In the corner, Marcher. Oh, Hawkins, no. And at the end of the half, Ethan has held Summit to just 6 points.
They didn't score at all in the second quarter.
In that second quarter. We're back with some halftime entertainment after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
Welcome back to the Huron Arena halftime of our second semifinal game with Ethan with the lead over Summit. Some halftime entertainment for you. Check in with our public address announcer, Josh Hader.
The Sanborn Central Woonsocket Blackhawks winter guard is currently the only competitive winter guard in South Dakota. The team has spent the last few months perfecting a routine and competing in the North Star Circuit, which is located in Minneapolis. The Blackhawks winter guard is under the direction of Mr. Brett Kroger and led by captains Ambria Smith, Mackenzie Peterson, and Brianne Brandenburg. Routine and choreography written by Ambria Smith. Please welcome the Blackhawks winter guard as they perform their show, Shatter Me.
I see the stars.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to direct your attention to the area in front of the band. The tournament band that is playing for today's session of the state basketball tournament is from Gregory High School, under the direction of Jared Opp. In appreciation for the fine music the band has provided during the games, Joe Auk, Assistant Executive Director of the South Dakota High School Activities Association, is now presenting to Jared Opp, Director of the Gregory High School Band, a plaque to commemorate the day. Please give the band a big state tournament round of applause.
And so at halftime, it is Ethan on top of Summit, 20-6. We'll be back to take a look at some stats from this first half after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Championship event is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, by SDN Communications, and by the Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota.
With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. Craig, real quick, there's the stats. Summit shooting 13%.
Statisticians are not going to get carpal tunnel tonight on this one. Not a lot of shots made. But you know what? It's because of the defense, though, on both sides. You know, even though Summit has only did not score in the second quarter, again, they still held a pretty good Ethan team to only 8 points.
Exactly.
In the second quarter.
And so we are at halftime. Ethan looking to stay undefeated. Summit looking to keep their run to a championship going. Ethan will have the ball to start the second half. Rustlers will go with their starting lineup. Hawkins, Janae Gustafson, Darby Gustafson, Ellie Hone, and Casey Barcher.
Zerbo is in the game for Summit. She's playing with three fouls. Everybody else, pretty good.
Janae Gustafson. Four sophomores and a senior in the starting lineup for Ethan. Ellie Hone out top to Gustafson. She'll take the three. No good, and the rebound controlled by the Eagles.
Yeah, Summit, they're just daring her to shoot from out there. They're not too worried about her shooting from beyond the arc.
Paraboom, Revlin, Chamley, Zerbel, and Nealon. The shot up, no good. How many shots like that have happened tonight, Craig? We're
halfway down and out.
You thought it was in.
Summit, 1 of 11 from the arc.
Count it and one. The drive by Hawkins.
Redlin will pick up the foul. Look at number four.
Free throw not there, and the rebound by Nicolette Neeland. Zone defense by the Rustlers. They opened up in a man-to-man tonight. But since that time, they have gone to a zone. They were obviously concerned with the outside shooting ability of the Eagles.
The last field goal by Summit came at the 2.5 minute mark of the first quarter.
There's a steal by the Rustlers. Ellie Hone comes up with it.
Don't think they're too worried about Hone and Gustafson shooting from beyond the arc.
Nope, but Ellie Hone hits the 18-footer. Nice save back in bounds, but it goes right to the Rustlers. Gustafson to the basket, score it. It has been domination to start this second half by the Ethan Rustlers. They have extended their lead now to 20 points. Nealon lost the handle. Zerbel got it back, but Gustafson knocked it out of bounds. It will stay with the Eagles.
Well, Chamley and Paraboom and Zerbel Need to start lighting it up here.
Double teamed in the corner. They get it out to Chamley.
There's Paraboom. Paraboom's got to get herself open.
Nealon.
Got to get herself open.
Yep. She had, Paraboom had a couple of looks in that first half, but couldn't knock any down. And a timeout going to be called by Mark Omdahl. Program. There's the run out and the layup by Darby Gustafson, 6'1", and a senior.
Programming on South Dakota Public Broadcasting made possible through the support of people just like you. Next couple of weeks, SDPB offered you the opportunity to become a member and invest in programs that matter. Special features like legendary talent, worthy ideas, and inspiring better living. Shows that highlight all that's great about South Dakota. So keep tuned to SDPB television through the month of March.
You can, of course, go to sdpb.org. Ball will stay with the Eagles. Chamley. Double team in the corner. Off back to Chamley. Reverse it to Paraboom. Nealon in the corner. Down low, they'll get it to Zirpel, and she is going to be fouled. That will go on Carly Gustafson, the 5'11 eighth grader who is in the lineup. And we'll step aside. Ethan with the 20-point lead. We're back to the Huron Arena after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Summit with the basketball. Craig, reiterate, the last time that Summit scored, their last field goal.
2:27 to go in the first quarter.
Nealon can't hit the backdoor layup, but she will step to the line and shoot two.
Hawkins picked up her third foul here for Ethan.
That is the second team foul on the Rustlers. Nicolette. Misses that one. 0 for 3 now at the free throw line.
Take a deep breath and release. Oop.
Jumper on the wing, no good. Rebound, Nealon muscles that one down.
Oh, that was a nice rebound, but got tied up by...
Gustafson, yep. That time what happened in alternating possession, it will belong to Summit. But that time she just, when she brought down the rebound, she turned into the defender, didn't realize she was there. Again, that zone so active for the Rustlers. See if they can find Chamley. She's open on the weak side, but defensively, good job by Barcher of getting over and shutting that down. Zirbel. Now Chamley's open, hits it. That is a scoring drought that has just come to a merciful end for Summit.
Those last three passes were crisp, quick, beat the zone to the corner, gave Chamley a chance to get a nice shot up and in.
Gustafson will step to the line. Darby. Foul goes on number 12. That is Bluedorn, the 6-foot sophomore who's in the lineup for Summit. The second team foul on the Summit Eagles this half. Yeah. back up to a 19-point lead. Tamley to the basket, got it.
She's got 5 points on the night.
Two trips, two buckets. Now you got to get a stop if you're Summit. Barcher. Down low to Gustafson. Gustafson changed her pivot foot there and is called for the traveling violation. Again, the passing lane, that's the thing, Craig. You pointed it out. Summit has played very good defense tonight. It's just that Ethan is playing much better. But in that case, Gustafson went to make the pass, and the passing lane had closed. So she moved her feet, forcing the turnover.
Call me old school. Anytime that ball is in the paint, I'm shooting.
Chamley for three, short. Rebound controlled by Janae Gustafson.
Yeah, we talked about this Ethan squad. Four sophomores and a senior. All those schools in District 8, they're not feeling very good about that. You know, I mean, Hanson had a great year this year.
They did.
At 16-4. Bridgewater Emory, they were 13-7.
And I wonder how many of those four losses for Hanson were to Ethan. Ethan just going to run some clock now. Again, this is a classic move by Tom Young, Dr. Tom. He is an eye doctor. Again, in case you missed it, last night I said he was a dentist, and I know better. But
Michaela Zerbel, first foul of the night.
Third team foul on Summit. But Tom Young, when he was coaching Mitchell Christian, he had a lot of success, but those teams were hardly dynamic. He was not afraid to just go ahead and eat up time, shorten up the game, win some low-scoring games if that's what it took to win. It's kind of like Kurt Fredrickson up at Northern State. Kurt had a great quote on our show, Calling All Sports with Marco and Mike H. He said, my job isn't to entertain people. My job is to win games.
Now, the lowest output by Ethan this year was that game with Mount Vernon Plankinton. That was a 35-34 game. Second lowest offensive output of the year.
Mount Vernon Plankinton, of course, they are in the girls' tournament, aren't they?
The Class A.
The Class A, yeah. Baraboom.
Again on his zone. You got to pass that ball around real quick. Sharp. Find that open spot for the shot.
Chamley to Zerbel. Zerbel in the corner. Goes inside.
There you go.
Turnaround jumper. Oh. No good. Chamley, the weak side rebound, and she's fouled. So she'll step to the line and shoot two. The shot was put up by Bluedorn.
Janae Gustafson with three fouls.
Free throw is good. Again, a chance to close this gap without any time going off the clock.
Chamley has scored all the points here for Summit in this third quarter. All 7 points in this quarter from Chamley.
Hawkins brings it into the front court. Gives it off on the right side over to Carly Gustafson, the eighth grader. Hawkins. To Darby Gustafson, and we've got a foul whistle. That's going to go on Hawkins on an illegal screen.
Her fourth.
So Summit is going to have an opportunity for the last shot here of the quarter, if that's what they choose to do.
Hawkins will come out. Coming in is Janae Gustafson.
Here comes Chamley. Carissa Chamley, 5'9 and a senior, playing with a torn ACL in her left knee. Gustafson out defensively. Paraboom. Off to Chamley. Good if it goes. Yes! Count it! 10 points in the quarter for Chamley. Summit showing some life. And we're back with quarter number four after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Take a look. That's a nice pass by Paraboom. She kind of gets lucky. Chamley, clearly the ball in the air before the buzzer goes off. Nice work by the camera folks, many of whom are students this weekend helping us out on our broadcast.
Mike, it's only a 12-point ball game here.
There's a foul out front. That's going to go on Michaela Zirpel. Yeah, Summit showed some life there, scoring 10 points in the quarter. The bad news is for Summit, Ethan scored 8, so they only gained a couple of points on him. Hawkins is back in the ball game despite the fact that she has 4 fouls. Darby Christensen gives it up to Hawkins, the drive and the layup.
She's got 4 points, the second basket of the game.
Back to a 14-point lead. Large contingent of fans from Ethan. Nicolette Niebuhr hits the 3. And a timeout called by Mark Omdahl. Swing it into the corner. And Nicolette Nieland hits the 3. She's known for her inside game. Alex, her sister, is known for her outside game. Actually, Alex, we talked about it last night. She was a kid that could score just about every way possible. But that's a huge 3 coming from Nieland.
Only her 4th tray of the year.
So that brings it back to just an 11-point lead.
Well, Summit's only got 1 timeout left.
Right.
They'll get the TV timeout here in a couple of minutes.
Remember, Mark Omdahl used a couple early. He was hardly halfway through that first quarter and had used 2 already. But that was when Ethan was really setting the tone for this game.
Paraboom is the leading scorer for Summit on the year, 15 points a game. She's got 1 basket, 1 free throw. And Zirbel averaging 11 points a game. She's got 1 field goal.
So the Ethan Rustlers with the 11-point lead and the basketball. Hawkins into the front court against man-to-man defense from the Summit Eagles.
Mikey, if you're the Rustlers, you're looking for Darby right here.
And now a trap defense, but open 3 in the corner. No good. Christensen, the putback, no good. And the rebound pulled down by Michaela Zirbel.
Well, Summit going to make this interesting or not?
Chamley. No. Rebound.
Oh, she had a nice look at it.
Into the front court. Here comes Janae Gustafson. Janae covered up by Chamley. Darby Gustafson. Goes with that left hand, spins into the lane, and a reach-in foul on Michaela Zirbel.
That will be her 3rd. And Mike, 2 more fouls by Summit puts Ethan in the bonus.
4th quarter, the winner gets Sully Buttes, the top seed in this tournament, who defeated DeSmet in a very entertaining game earlier tonight. The steal by Chamley.
7th turnover tonight by Ethan.
Another 3. Yes! Nicolette Nieland had 3 3-pointers on the year. She has 2 in the last minute and a half. And a timeout called by Tom Young. It's down to an 8-point lead.
With that zone, Pass that ball quickly, find the open shooter, and you knock it down.
Nealand had an open three look earlier in the game and took it. We talked about the fact that if she can hit one of those, it changes things defensively. She hadn't taken another one until recently, but she's hit the last two. And there's life back for the Summit Eagles.
It'll live and die by the three.
Yeah, Summit is going in athletically with Wabe next year in all sports. They will be the Mustangs.
That's correct.
They are also going in with Wilmont and Wabe for football next year. So tiny Summit, South Dakota, trying to make one final run to go with some other championships that they've got and a great basketball tradition. Steve Gapp and Lori Wolliver, and they've had players through the years. Out top, the wrestlers, Rachel Hawkins. Hawkins, the heartbeat pretty much of this team. She'll give it off to Darby Gustafson. Hawkins is playing with four fouls. Ellie Hone, left side. Janae Gustafson. Again, Ethan will go ahead and shorten up this game. They don't mind the time ticking off the clock. Very, very patient. Darby again holds the ball high over her head before dribbling. She'll go to the basket, score it, and the foul. Blue Dorn with the foul. Look at the crossover. And then finishing. The three-point play stretches the lead back for Ethan. We're back with the final 4:58 after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN, I'm Mike Henriksen from SportsMax Radio and our daily show, Calling All Sports. Great to have you joining us. The winner of this one takes on Sully Buttes in the championship tomorrow night.
Only loss by Sully Buttes, Ethan.
Eagles showing signs of life here in this third and fourth quarter. They had gotten it to within eight with the three-point play by Gustafson. Brings it back to an 11-point lead. Paraboom with the drive, puts it up, no good. Nealand to put back, no, but she'll step to the line and shoot two.
Nealand did a good job following the drive by Paraboom.
There you see it off the front of the rim, but Nealand is right there to clean up. Nealand has struggled at the free throw line tonight. She's hit a couple of three-pointers like there was nothing to it, but she has really struggled at the line. Of course, sometimes after you miss a couple, then you kind of start pressing a little bit. And look at that one, perfect.
7 points on the night for Nicolet.
10-point lead at the 4:25 mark. Hawkins, front court, covered by Zerbel. Back it goes to Janae Gustafson. Darby Gustafson. Yes, the three Gustafsons are sisters. Hawkins gives it up to Ellie Hone. Back to Janae Gustafson.
Ever since Ethan got up to that 20-point lead.
Shot was missed, but Hawkins got her own rebound and put it back up.
Ever since Ethan got that 20-point lead at 26-6.
Yep.
Summit's been on a 17-7 run.
Free throw is up and good. Back into the lineup for Summit is Sierra Redland, the 5'6 senior. Checking out is Blue Dorn. That one's up and good as well. The Rustlers, an excellent free throw shooting team. Able to keep Summit at arm's distance. 3:40 left to play in the game. Paraboom, Chamley. Paraboom to three. Put back, Nealon.
Nealon was all by herself on that low block.
She's got 9 points on the night. Back to within 10. Hawkins into the front court. Rustlers are in the bonus if the Eagles foul. Nice pass and then layup down low. Ellie Hone from Gustafson. Back to a 12-point lead, and Dr. Tom Young once and gets a timeout. Great pass. And again, Darby Gustafson, 6'1", obviously has been taught through the years so effectively, holding that ball high over her head, making herself as big as possible, and then putting nice zip on the pass, too.
South Dakota Public Broadcasting able to provide coverage of the state high school basketball championships and other quality shows that you enjoy because of the generous support of viewers like you. Take a moment, express your appreciation, log on to sdpb.org, and click on Donate Now to make an investment in programs that matter. And we thank you for your support.
Full court pressure now by Ethan. Oh, now they're going to drop back. Probably maybe go into a little trap. Nope, they're going man-to-man. That's what they're doing. They're going back to man-to-man defense. Into the front court. Zerbel gives it up. Paraboom, a long three. Too long, out of bounds, last touched by Ellie Hone of Ethan. So it will stay with Summit. Paraboom set to inbound. Better get it in. 5 second violation. That's a turnover.
That was good defense by the Rustlers. Really good.
Yet again. Hone will give it up into the front court. Janae Gustafson. Gustafson covered by Nealon. Gustafson, she's going to be fouled. That will be on Whitney Zerbel.
Her fourth.
That's her fourth. So the fouls piling up for Summit. That is the eighth, so it's still a 1-1. But a chance for the Rustlers to ice this game at the line over the final 2:43. Gustafson now with 16 points on the night. Chamley, will bring it into the front court. Chamley, pull-up jumper on the wing. No good, was partially blocked, and Hone comes up with the loose ball. Here comes Hone into the front court. Double team, gets it back to Hawkins. Almost a steal by Michaela Zerbel. Janae Gustafson. There's the foul by Michaela Zerbel. That is the ninth foul, so still the 1-1, and Hawkins steps to the free throw line. Rachel, whose mom was the most valuable track athlete at the 1988 state track meet, will step to the free throw line. No good. And the rebound controlled by Summit. Paraboom has the ball tipped. Zerbel, though, comes up with it. Down low, shot up, no good. An excellent look, but Michaela Zerbel runs it down. Whitney Zerbel wasn't able to get it to fall. Paraboom to the basket, no. Rebound controlled, Ellie Hone. And under 2 minutes to play, a 14-point lead. And stepping to the free throw line will once again be Hawkins.
Well, Summit had their looks on that last possession.
Hawkins is an 80% free throw shooter, but she just missed the last time that she was at the free throw line. It is double bonus for the rest of the game. So every time that Summit commits a foul, Ethan will be shooting two. Oh for three at the free throw line. Chamley into the front court. Zerbel lost the handle, stays with the Eagles. It was knocked out of bounds by the Rustlers. Paraboom will inbound to Zerbel. Back to Paraboom. Was open for a moment, didn't take the shot. She'll drive instead, the step through, and she'll step to the line, shooting two. Still an ever faint glimmer of hope for Summit.
Good drive by Paraboom. Being aggressive.
Hit the free throws with the clock not moving. Come up with a steal or a stop. No good. Rebound pulled down by Gustafson. Gustafson. They'll try to get to somebody to foul.
Janae Gustafson, a 60% free throw shooter.
A timeout was called before a foul was whistled. Tom Young called the timeout. It is a full. Craig, what's going on at the other tournaments today? While you look that up, I will remind you that we'll get underway tomorrow with our consolation coverage at noon Central, 11 o'clock Mountain Time. Another full day of basketball. That's been one of the greatest additions that South Dakota Public Broadcasting has brought you, is all 12 games from all six locations.
5.5 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Sioux Falls, Washington leading Harrisburg 37-29.
The winner of that one gets Sioux Falls O'Gorman, correct?
That is correct in the championship. And I don't have an update on the A's.
Okay.
Getting anything out of that.
St. Thomas More did win earlier this evening.
Yes, they did. So all three of the top seeds advancing to the championship game.
So with 1:10 left to play in the game, Ethan will have the basketball in their own front court.
Ethan is 12 of 30 from the floor tonight. 0 for 6 beyond the arc. 15 of 20 from the free throw line.
Summit with just one timeout left. And foul by Paraboom. That is going to put Darby Gustafson at the free throw line. Darby.
70%.
One no good, but she'll shoot the second.
Well, Ethan has missed 4 free throws in a row. Sierra Redland back in. Get another 3-point shooter on the floor for Summit.
She hits that one. The missed free throws is what has left the door slightly open for a comeback to the Eagles, but baseline. Nope. Got to get a shot off quick. Ball knocked out of bounds. It will stay with Summit. And Mark Omdahl just said to his team, what are you waiting for? Shoot the ball. Kayla Zerbel. She'll try to get it off to Sierra Redland, and a jump ball. It will stay with Summit. Ethan holding Summit to 26 points tonight. Chamley will spin, put it up, no good. Rebound, Nealon saved it. It goes into the arms of Barcher, and Barcher is going to be fouled. Marching to the other end to shoot free throws, Casey Barcher. Casey on the year, an 83% free throw shooter. Casey's big brother, Blake, was Spirit of Sioux winner a year ago at the Class B tournament.
First point on the night for Casey Barcher.
Summit got it to within 30-22 at the 6-minute mark. But since that time, the Ethan Rustlers have built their lead back up. Paraboom loses the handle on it. Christensen. And now Mark Omdahl telling his team no fouls. Going to back off. Ball loose on the floor. Oh, Zirbel not hearing the instructions on no fouls. Just going for the steal. And that'll do it. The Ethan Rustlers continue with their stifling defense that they have used all season long and here in the tournament. They defeat the Summit Eagles by a final of 41-26. Ethan will now move on to take on Sully Buttes tomorrow night. Sully Buttes, the number one seed. Their only loss on the year has been to the Ethan Rustlers. Ethan undefeated. Summit will be taking on DeSmet in what should be a very entertaining third place game tomorrow night at 6 o'clock Central and 5 o'clock Mountain. Craig Maddock is standing by with the coach, Tom Young. Craig?
Coach, two really good defenses. You were held to your second lowest offensive performance tonight overall. What kind of a game was that for you guys?
Well, you know, I really expected this kind of game. I saw Summit on TV, and Coach Omdahl is just a great coach. I knew he was going to be prepared for us, and he tried to take away some stuff, which he did. We tried to do the same, and, you know, our defense has been what's carried us all year long, and it's just been amazing.
They came within eight with 30-22 late in the ball game. Did you change anything at that particular time?
Well, you know, just at the timeout, just tell them, you know, we've got to play with poise, and we weren't going to hold the ball. We're going to try to score, but we wanted to be really patient and get the shot that we wanted, and we did. And our senior came up big for us, and then we got a couple layups off our offense, which sealed the deal.
You got four sophomores that start. They look pretty poised tonight.
You know, four sophomores and an eighth grader coming in right away, playing a lot of minutes. These girls are way beyond their years as far as poise.
Coach, congrats. We'll see you tomorrow night.
Thank you very much.
Coach Tom Young. They get by Summit, and the undefeated season continues. Mike, tomorrow night it's a rematch of a game earlier in the season. Sully Buttes' only loss was to Ethan. More about it on the way as we're at the Class B Girls Basketball Tournament on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. Ethan comes up with the huge defensive stand tonight, and they move into the championship. Take a look at some second half highlights. Mostly Ethan, but a nice drive by Hawkins there. And then the jumper along the baseline by Ellie Hone. Here comes the run out and the layup by Darby Gustafson. Summit did show some life, though. Three-pointer in the corner, up and good by Chamley. Another bucket by Chamley. She had all 10 points, including that at the buzzer at the end of the third quarter. But Miller with Hawkins on the left-handed drive. The shot is up and good for three by Nicolette Nealon. And just for good measure, Nicolette scores another one. But in the end, too much of the Ethan Rustlers as the drive there by Darby Gustafson. Craig, take a look at the stats.
Ethan outscored Summit in the second half, 21-20. Unfortunately, Summit didn't score at all in the second quarter.
There you see three-pointers. Ethan didn't hit one. They didn't need to. They also won the rebounding battle. Summit with 12 turnovers. And so we'll be back to set up tomorrow for you after this timeout. You're watching South Dakota Girls Class B Championships from the arena in beautiful downtown Huron. Back after this.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Championship event is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, by SDN Communications, and by the Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota.
And so we are set for our third and final day. Tomorrow we will have consolation round action for you coming up at noon Central and 11 o'clock Mountain Time. But tomorrow night, DeSmet and Summit in what should be a very entertaining third place game after our opening ceremonies. And then for the title, Sully Buttes and Ethan, a rematch that Ethan won earlier this year. But a team that Sully Buttes would love to have another crack at, the top two seeds in this tournament. For all the men and women behind the scenes, running the cameras, doing the work in the truck, and a lot more, I'm Mike Henriksen. For Craig Maddock, thanks so much for joining us on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. We'll see you tomorrow afternoon.